हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू हिस्ट्री एंड सिविक्स क्लास फॉर क्लास 7. वी वर डूइंग लेसन नंबर 8, द मुगल एम्पायर, विच इज़ ऑन पेज नंबर 86 ऑफ योर हिस्ट्री एंड सिविक्स बुक. टॉपिक्स डिस्कस्ड इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो: रेवेन्यू एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन, लोकल रेवेन्यू, सेंट्रल रेवेन्यू, करेंसी एंड ट्रेड. लेट्स रिकॉल द टर्म्स: जिजिया, खाम्स, पत्ता, कबूलियत, लीनियंट, Muezzin. Topics to be discussed in today's video: transport and communication, espionage, religious policy, architecture, estimate. Terms to be discussed in the video: espionage, the practice of spying, infantry, foot soldiers, mausoleum, building housing a tomb. We have discussed in the previous video about the reforms made by Sher Shah Suri in trade, currency and land revenue system. In today's video, we will discuss about Sher Shah Suri's reforms made in transport and communication, his religious policies, his spy system and architectural buildings made by Sher Shah Suri. Sher Shah built an excellent network of roads throughout his empire. He built up an excellent system of transport and communication. The objectives to set up the better communication were: the soldiers and officials could move quickly when required throughout the empire. The trade and commerce were promoted through good communication and transport system. Effective transport made the traveling comfortable and easy. Roads served as a dark chonkies of the postal department. Through proper postal services, messages and news could be sent from different part of the kingdom. Let's read now. Transport and communication. Sher Shah built up an excellent system of transport and communication that served the following objectives: quick movement of the army troops and officials as and when required throughout the empire. Promotion of trade and commerce made traveling comfortable and easy. Roads served as a dark chockies of the postal department. The government was supplied news from the distant part of the kingdom. We have discussed this part in the beginning. Now let's continue with the next reading. Sher Shah built the Sar-e-Azam or the modern Grand Trunk Road, GT Road. It connected Sonargaon, Bengal in the east to Peshawar in the northwest. Fruit trees were planted on the both sides of these roads. Sher Shah built 1700 sarais, rest houses, at regular intervals with separate quarters for Hindus and Muslims. Each sarai had a well and a mosque with an imam and a muezzin. Muezzin means a person who calls Muslims for prayers from the minaret of the mosque. These roads were provided with rest houses or sarais at the intervals. 1700 sarais were constructed with separate rooms for Hindus and Muslims. He followed a policy of religious tolerance and placed people in the administration according to their merit. Trees were planted on the both sides of the roads and mukaddams were responsible for the safety of travelers and their property. The sarais gradually became centers of trade with towns and cities developing around them. Horse riders delivered post from one chowki to the next. Each sarai had a well, a mosque with imam and a muezzin. A police official was also posted at each sarai to maintain law and order. Espionage. Sher Shah had an excellent department of intelligence whose head was called Daroga Dark Chowki. A large number of news writers and spies were appointed under him that brought news from every corner of the empire. Spies were also posted in all the important towns and markets. Espionage means spy system. Sher Shah's efficient administrative system largely depended upon his well-organized spy system. The king kept himself posted with the minutest happening in his kingdom. He had an excellent department of intelligence whose head was called Daroga Dark Chowki.
a large number of news writers and spies means jasus, were appointed under him that brought news from every corner of his empire.
The spies were kept at all the important places and at all the important affairs. Let's start with the next topic. Shershah was an orthodox Muslim. Orthodox means Kattar in his private life. Publicly, he followed a policy of religious tolerance. He did not disturb the Hindus and did not break any Hindu images or demolish, means destroy, Hindu temples during his reign. He employed a large number of Hindus in infantry, means foot soldiers. Although Shershah was an orthodox Muslim, in his private life, Shershah followed a policy of religious tolerance towards the Hindus. He did not disturb the Hindus. He did not break any Hindu images or destroy any Hindu temples during his reign. He placed Hindu generals Baramjit Gaur in his army. Let's move further. Architecture. Shershah was a great builder. He built the fort of Rohtasgarh on the river Jhelum to protect his northwest frontier. He also built the Purana Qila in Delhi, which is a fine example of Indo-Islamic architecture. His own mausoleum at Sasaram in Bihar is the best example of his architecture. Here the word mausoleum means a building housing on a tomb. Shershah Suri was a great builder. He built Fort of Rohtasgarh. Rohtasgarh Fort is one of the ancient fortress of India, which located on the river Jhelum in the Pakistani province of Punjab. The fortress was built during the reign of Shershah Sur. The fort was built to protect his northwest frontier. The old fort, Purana Qila, in Delhi, was one of the oldest forts in India. It was constructed by the Afghan king Shershah Suri, which is a fine example of the Indo-Islamic architecture. The tomb of Shershah Suri is in Sasaram of Bihar, India. The tomb was built in the memory of Emperor Shershah Suri, who defeated the Mughal rulers and founded the Sur Empire in northern India. Let's continue with the next topic, estimate. Shershah was an efficient administrator and a brave military general. During his short reign of 5 years, he successfully established a vast empire in North India that stretched from Bengal in the east to Indus in the west. He was a reformer king. He reformed the revenue, administration, judiciary, army, and currency of his empire. He was a benevolent, means kind, ruler who undertook various measures for the general welfare of his subjects. He is one of the most remarkable rulers of medieval Indian history. According to Keane, no government, not even the British, has shown so much of wisdom as this Pathan. Shershah was a capable and efficient general. Although his reign was only for 5 years, yet he established a sound system of administration. He established a large empire in North India that stretched from Bengal in the east to the Indus in the west. He was known as Reformer King. He made many reforms in justice, administration, army, trade, and transport system. He was king who had all the supreme powers in his hands. He undertook various measures for his subjects. He is one of the remarkable rulers of the medieval Indian history. Many historians wrote words of praise for him. According to Keane, no government, not even British, has shown so much of wisdom as this Pathan. So students, this is the end of the today's topic as well as of the lesson number 8. I hope you understood the full lesson. You are able to solve the exercises by yourself. Don't forget to learn the full terms. I will come with the next chapter, with the next videos. Thank you. Have a nice day.